Good day guys, welcome to Chartered Accountants Academy video tutorials. Today we're going to be revising the CTA 2019 test 1, the monthly paper. So I'm going to be focusing on required C. So on required C, before we do anything, I'm not going to be focusing on figures, nor am I going to be focusing on much of the calculations. I'm just going to be helping you to come up with the figures. Also, I'm also going to give you an exam approach that you should do when you're in an exam. So what was our required? We expected to prepare the expected variable income statement for the laptop manufacturing for the first month of production, and all assumptions used were expected to be stated. Confirm. So when we want to prepare an income statement, what does an income statement detail? Especially if it's a variable income statement, that is very important. So let's go to our solution page. So this is our solution page. We're going to do a variable income statement. Then if it's an income statement, first and foremost, we have sales. Confirm. We also owe our revenue. After our revenue, we're going to subtract variable costs, and these costs are both production and admin or any other thing. As long as it's variable, it's going to be subtracted. After we subtract our variable costs, what are we going to get? We are going to get our contribution. Right here, after our contribution, we're going to less our fixed costs, and after we less our fixed costs, we're going to get our net profit. So in an exam, this is the required, and you are expected to come up with this. Whatever you do, you should make sure that you end up having sales, variable costs, and less fixed costs. So in an exam, the best way to do this is to attack the questions that are where you see there are easy marks that you can get. So let's go down to our scenario so that we can pick up the points. Okay, so our information for this required was basically starting from the manufacturing in performance, and then we're given all these information. So let's pick fabric. Is this a variable or is a fixed cost? This one is a variable cost. This one, variable cost. The arm is a variable cost. Another arm is a variable cost. Internal fastener, variable cost. This one, variable cost. Embroidery is per bag, so it's a variable cost. Quality control in manufacturing overheads, this we're going to go to note 5. So the easiest way to do this, you see this fabric as a knot, zip as a knot. Armstrong doesn't have a knot, which means this 2.4, we can just take it straight to our workings. It was also important to note that we want to produce 10,000 units in the first month. So our income statement, we're going to be doing it on a total basis, and then our units is going to be 10,000 units. They're all expected to be sold, and there'll be no closing inventory. Thus, the 10,000 units just are going to be used. We're also told that the selling price of each bag is expected to enable a markup of 45% on variable cost. So if you go to our working now, we already know that our sales revenue or our sales is going to be variable cost times 1.4. Is it 45 or it's 40? Let me just confirm. It was 45%. So whatever we get on our variable cost, this is our variable cost, we're going to multiply it by 1.45 to get our sales revenue. So this one, done. Okay, so now let's look at our variable cost. Our variable cost, we had, so I'm just going to write them all: fabric, zip, armstring plastic, padding, and everything, right? Since they are all variable costs. So You said we have fabric, we also have the zip, we had the armstring, up strap. Confirm you don't mark my spellings, eh? This one is the fabric and with arm strap, some plastic. We also have padding. We also have antenna, fasteners. We have our direct labor. We have our embroidery. So for now, let's wait here. So let's go for the easy marks. As we said earlier on, we said the points that don't have knots are going to be the easy mark. So this one doesn't have up strap fabric. It's $3 per meter and we expect to use 2.4 per unit. So it's just going to be 2.4 times 10k. And then this one up strap doesn't have a knot. It's just going to be 1.5 times 10k. Direct labor doesn't have a knot, so it's going to be 13.5 times 10k. And then these ones have knots. So can you see, if you do this one and this one and this one, if there is one mark per each, that means you already have three marks without you having to think about anything, right? So confirm we have done. Let me just use a different color pen. Let me use the green one. So we are seeing so we say the armstring fabric, this one is done, and the plastic, this one is done, and the direct labor, this one is done. Let's go back to the ones that have some knots. So let's go back to our red pen. Okay, so if we go to the fabric knot, it was a knot one. So we told on knot one that our fabric is to be sourced in South Africa, and then the exchange rate is 1:40 and additional premiums ranging from 135 to 140. So which premium are you going to use? I'm sure the exchanging from the rands to the dollar, it won't be a challenge, but which premium are you going to use? Are you going to use 135? And why? Are you going to use 140 and why? So in this case, this I would quite expect us to state our assumptions. We'll do our assumptions. So as for me, I would say we use 140 since we are doing this for, we are bringing income statement for decision making. It's best if we use 140% as our premium so that you can cater for any fluctuations between 135 to 140. So we just use the 140% premium. So on converting our premium, let me just do it right here. So we are saying $1 is equal to 14 rands. And then we expect we need 224 rands. How much is this going to be? It's going to be more. It's just simple proportion. And after you do this, for example, say you get 22.4, confirm, pay unit. And then you're going to multiply this by the additional premium that you're going to pay. So instead you're going to be using 140. So this one, so if premium is 140, that means we're going to be paying this one times 140, which means our premium is going to be 240%. Confirm. And then you get your answer. After you get your answer, you're just going to multiply it by your 10,000 units and you get units from fabric. Then let's move on to the next variable cost. The variable cost was the zip, which was $5 per meter, and there's information on knot 2. If we go to knot 2, the supplier has indicated that 10% increase in the price. So we're just going to say our $6 times 1.1 to increase it by 10%. Easy math there. Let's go to our next. So this one done, this one done. Let's go to our padding. Padding is also referring us to note 1, which we are going to use a true 40 percentage additional premium. So easy math, you just convert this 112 to your dollars, and then you put your 240% premium. Then if you go to internal fasteners, this was on note 3. Let's go to note 3 and find out what they were saying. Okay, so on note 3, we expect that 1 in every 20 fasteners is going to be normally expected not to be appropriately qualified, which means this is a normal loss. So if you're saying 1 of every 20 is going to be normal loss, how many units do we need? We need 10,000 units, meaning we're going to lose 500 fasteners in total. So for us, if you want to make an order, we're going to make an order of how many fasteners in total? We're going to order 10,000 plus the normal loss, which means we're going to order 10,500 units for us to get 10,000 units. So this 500 is going to be normal loss. So we're just going to say 10,500 times the cost per unit. Cost per unit. Confirm. Easy mark there. Then let's move on. So this one, done. Let's move on to embroidery. It was on note 5. Note 4. Embroidery, note 4. Embroidery is $5 per each bag. Is marked there. So it's just going to be 5. 5 times 10K, which is going to be your total cost. And then machinery will be rented out at 18,000. This is an annual rate. So since we are calculating a variable income statement for 1 month, we're just going to divide the 18,000 over 12 months to get 1 month rentals. Confirm. And then this part, is it a variable cost or it's a fixed cost? I would say it's a fixed cost because these are rental, they're not going to change. So here we're just going to see our rental, and then we put our answer here. This is how you come up with the solution. Once you're doing your variable, you can also, if you find a fixed cost, you can just put it there. So we're done with our rental and embroidery, and then quality control and manufacturing overhead. This is not 5 and not 6, so just allow me to go there and not come back to this page. So note 5, if a monthly salary of $750 is going to be paid to the supervisor. So if it's a monthly salary, is this variable or fixed? Fixed cost. So you just put it on your fixed cost. Your fixed cost says there. Now you have a salary, $750. And then if you go back to your quality control, quality checks we've done, and then our manufacturing overheads. So this one, if you're given this table, what do you think the examiner is leading you to? You should know the examiner is leading you to a high low method to calculate your variable cost and your fixed cost. So if you do a high low, you get your variable cost, you multiply this by 10k, since the number of units, and also your variable, your fixed cost, you put it on the fixed cost schedule. Then that note is done. So now that we are done with our calculations of the variable cost, so here we're going to have overheads, the variable part from our high low. Then put it over here, put everything over here, put everything. Then the total that we get on these costs, if we add a 45% markup, we're going to get our sales revenue done. And then if we subtract our sales revenue from our variable, total variable cost, we are going to get our contribution. And then if we subtract our, so here we also have our overheads and the fixed cost there, the fixed part. And then if we subtract our fixed cost from the contribution, we are going to get our net profit. then it just gets you 15 marks for correct calculation and 1 mark for presentation and layout since you have done this. I hope you have benefited from this video, ladies and gentlemen. If you have further questions, feel free to visit our offices or contact us on the departmental email, which is manfin@caa.ac.zw. Thank you.